You need to know who you are. I mean, this is a key thing about this book, really, because, you know, the first half of this book, I talk about, you need to be able to, you know, you need to understand your story, because the moment you understand your story and you tell it, then it will help you understand who you are and why you are today. And what I would say to anyone listening today, if you do not understand your story and you don't understand why you're struggling as a human being, then you will continue to struggle. We need to be able to know why we catastrophize. We need to understand why we're anxious sometimes. We need to understand why we have these behaviors or patterns that we get stuck in, because we don't just get them by magic. They evolve, they develop. We're all programmed, all this neuropathway hardwiring that goes on in our formative years. It all happens because of what we experience in life. And I guess you need to understand that. So, to give a personal example, I didn't realize I was anxious until I left Northern Ireland.
Yeah. I mean, which is hilarious. This last time, yeah.
I mean, I was living in a war zone and I think, and I don't have anxiety because I was too busy functioning and getting on with it. And then of course I leave and I come to London and a car backfires and I'm bloody on the floor because I'm jumping or like suddenly I realize, oh my God. And then I can then start to match my story and tell my story and think, oh God, there's a lot of things that happened in my life that helped me understand who I am and why I struggle. And I think most people need that to happen, because otherwise you hear people and say, oh God, my life's rubbish, or I'm crap, or I'm rubbish, or I'm shit, or I'm not good enough, whatever the context might be. And you think, no, you're not. No, you're not. That doesn't define who you are. Stuff happened to you and you struggle. And that's all you need to understand. You need to understand the what's happened and why it might relate to how and why you struggle. And then when that coin drops, it's quite powerful. People think, oh, this is not me. I'm not a complete waste of time. I'm not rubbish. Maybe there is more to me. And that for me is really, I mean, they're the kind of the light bulb. They're the explosive moments in therapy when people think, oh God, it's not that bad after all, you know? And maybe I can do something about this, and maybe there is hope, and there is always hope. You've heard me talk about this before. There is always hope. And that's when the magic happens. Then when people think, okay, well, I'll say to someone, you learn to worry. That's okay. But you can also learn to unworry.